Oh, hey! Welcome back! Caroline here. Today, we're exploring a fascinating question. Can we build a star on Earth? Imagine how useful that would be for generating energy. Every second, the sun transforms over 600 million tons of hydrogen into helium through a process called nuclear fusion. This releases enough energy to meet Earth's energy needs millions of times over. Fusion is the ultimate energy source, clean and fueled by hydrogen, the most abundant element in the universe. Seriously, it's everywhere. But here's the catch. While fusion happens naturally in stars, recreating it on Earth is an immense scientific and engineering challenge. Fusion requires extreme conditions to occur. And then there's the small matter of containing that kind of energy. It's like trying to trap a star in a box. So, what's the process behind nuclear fusion? How does it power the stars? And could it power our future? Let's find out. To grasp the concept of nuclear fusion, we must first examine the structure of an atom. At the center of every atom is a nucleus, a tiny, dense region made up of protons and neutrons. Protons have a positive charge, while neutrons have no charge. The nucleus is surrounded by electrons, which are negatively charged. Most chemical reactions involve changes in the arrangement of electrons. However, it's the nucleus itself that plays a key role in nuclear reactions. Nuclear fusion is a process where two light atomic nuclei combine to form a single heavier nucleus that is more stable. This releases energy because the resulting nucleus has a slightly smaller mass than the sum of the original nuclei. The difference in mass is converted into energy, as described by Einstein's famous equation, E equals mc squared. Since c represents the speed of light, a very large number, this equation conveys that a tiny amount of mass can produce an enormous amount of energy. To understand how this works in nature, let's take a closer look at the Sun, our solar system's natural fusion reactor. In the Sun's core, hydrogen collides at extraordinary speeds. Hold on, how does that work? Hydrogen nuclei are positively charged. Under normal conditions, these nuclei repel each other. It would be like trying to push the same poles of two magnets together. What characteristics of the Sun allow hydrogen nuclei to fuse despite repelling each other? Pause the video and make a prediction. In the Sun's core, the temperatures and pressure are extremely high. So high that the hydrogen nuclei overcome their natural resistance and even fuse into a new element, helium. But how does making a new molecule release energy? The answer lies in the concept of binding energy. Binding energy is the energy required to hold a nucleus together. When two nuclei fuse, the resulting larger nucleus is more tightly bound. This means the larger nucleus is more stable and takes less energy to hold together than the original smaller nuclei. The difference in binding energy between the original nuclei and the new one is released as light and heat. Every second, the sun produces an astonishing amount of energy through fusion. But this process isn't just about producing light and heat. It's the driving force behind the life and evolution of stars. Let's take a closer look at how this works. Now that we know how fusion works, let's explore its role in stars. Stars are born in massive clouds of gas and dust called nebulae. Over time, gravity pulls these particles together, compressing them into a dense core. As the core heats up and becomes denser, it reaches the high temperatures and pressures needed for hydrogen fusion. This marks the beginning of a star's life. Most stars begin by fusing hydrogen into helium, producing energy that pushes outward, counteracting gravity's inward pull. This balance keeps the star stable and shining. The Sun, for example, has been burning steadily for about 4.6 billion years, with enough hydrogen fuel to keep shining for another 5 billion years. Meanwhile, my phone can't even make it to lunch. Anyways, what happens when stars run out of hydrogen? As stars use up their hydrogen, fusion can shift to form progressively heavier elements like carbon and oxygen. In larger stars, this process continues until eventually the star forms iron. Why does it stop at iron? Because iron's nucleus is already as stable as possible. Fusing iron into heavier elements would require more energy than it releases. At this point, fusion can no longer produce the energy needed to push outward against gravity's inward pull. When stars exhaust their fuel, the balance between gravity and energy production is lost. What do you think happens to a star when the balance between gravity and energy production is lost? Pause the video and make a prediction. Well, their fate depends on their size. Smaller stars, like the Sun, shed their outer layers in a process called a planetary nebula, contributing lighter elements to the cosmos. In massive stars, the core collapses under immense gravity, triggering a supernova explosion. These supernovas scatter heavy elements into space, seeding new stars, planets, and even life itself. In fact, the carbon in your body and the oxygen you're breathing were created in the cores of ancient stars. Fusion isn't just a stellar process. It's the engine of the cosmos, responsible for everything from the light we see in the night sky to the elements that make up our world. But can we harness its power on Earth? You might wonder, don't we already use nuclear energy on Earth? We do. Nuclear power plants use a process known as nuclear fission. However, fusion and fission are two very different processes. Let's compare them. First, the similarities. Both nuclear fusion and nuclear fission are, well, nuclear reactions. This means they alter the structure of atomic nuclei. This is where their incredible power comes from. These processes break and reconfigure the forces that hold nuclei together. In both fusion and fission, the resulting nuclei or fragments are more stable than the original nuclei, meaning less energy is needed to bind them. The difference in this binding energy is released as usable energy. Although both involve nuclei and energy, the mechanisms of fusion and fission are fundamentally different. During fusion, light nuclei, like hydrogen, combine into a heavier, more stable nucleus. However, in fission, a heavy nucleus, like uranium, is split into smaller, more stable fragments. Another big difference in the two processes is the byproducts of materials left over after a reaction takes place. Fusion produces harmless helium, whereas fission creates long-lasting radioactive waste. Finally, let's consider the amount of energy produced. Fusion has the potential to produce far more energy than fission, using a fuel, hydrogen, that's virtually limitless. But while fission technology is well established, fusion is still in the experimental stage. In short, fusion is cleaner, more powerful, and safer than fission, but it's much harder to achieve. While fusion holds great promise, it's still years away from practical use, and fission remains a critical part of today's energy mix. So why is fusion so challenging to replicate on Earth? Let's explore a few of the obstacles scientists are working to overcome. If nuclear fusion is so great, why haven't we made it work on Earth yet? The answer lies in the extreme conditions fusion requires. In stars like the Sun, gravity creates immense pressure, crushing hydrogen nuclei together at temperatures of 15 million degrees Celsius. On Earth, we don't have that kind of natural gravity, so we need even higher temperatures to make up for it. We need temperatures of over 100 million degrees Celsius to fuse hydrogen on Earth. That's 6 times hotter than the sun's core. At those temperatures, hydrogen gas turns into plasma, a supercharged state of matter where atoms break apart into a mix of free-floating particles. This is a perfect environment for fusion to occur. However, containing plasma at temperatures of 100 million degrees is a monumental challenge. No material on Earth could survive such heat. To overcome this, scientists use powerful magnetic fields to create an invisible bottle that holds the plasma in place and prevents it from touching the reactor walls. This technique, called magnetic confinement, is a leading approach for achieving fusion on Earth. It's the foundation of devices like the tokamak, which is designed to maintain the stability of the plasma. But fusion experiments face significant challenges. Maintaining these extreme conditions is energy intensive, and even the tiniest instabilities in the plasma can cause a reaction to fail. Scaling up fusion will need major technological breakthroughs. Despite these challenges, scientists remain optimistic. Each experiment teaches us more about the process of fusion, both in stars and in reactors. So, could we ever trap a star in a box? Maybe not yet, but the effort itself is lighting the way toward a more sustainable future. Until next time, keep asking questions and let your curiosity shine as bright as the stars. Hey, hey.